How to lower stress in your life. Hi guys, my name is Lena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness. Welcome. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe because on this channel I share useful tips for your self-development. I help you to become happier and more successful in life. And today we're gonna talk about stress. Right now we are at the beginning of the winter holiday season, and usually holidays bring not only joy but lots of stress in our life. So today I will give you 7 tips that will help you to lower and to manage anxiety, stress and any tension and discomfort that you have in your life. All tips are going to be extremely simple and reasonable, and you can do it every day or every other day. So let's start. So tip number one, I have my notes, that's why I'm looking down. I just want to make sure that you receive everything that I prepared for you. So tip number one is learn how to use a calendar. If you never used calendar, then you might try to do it right now, because calendar will save a lot of time and will lower the stress in your life. When you have a calendar, you can use it for your personal use and for your business use. For example, in my calendar, and I like to use a paper calendar, and I use Google Calendar as well. So I like to use it for both. I have things to do for my business in my calendar. Like, for example, I have meetings with my private clients. I have time when I record my videos, and also I add my personal stuff, like I need to take my daughter to the doctor's appointment, or I need to pay my bills, or I need to, you know, plan the party for the holiday. I put everything in my calendar. This way it helps me to see things that I have to do within the week or within the month, and I can manage my time better. This can eliminate lots of stress that comes with things like late fees from the bank. If you forgot to pay your credit card bill and then you get in charge for something that was unexpected from you. You planned to do it, but you forgot, and now you have to pay the fees. So calendar will help you not only save your money, but also it will give you some peace of mind when you're planning things. And talking about the calendar, I would like to introduce the sponsor of today's video, and the sponsor is Silk and Sander, and they offer an amazing calendar that does not look like your regular calendar. It helps you to guide you through journaling. So it's a calendar, it's a journal, it's a mood tracker, it's a meal tracker, it has some habit trackers, and I will show you details at the end of this video. So please stay because I'm gonna open this package together with you, and I already started, I could not wait, so I kind of like started opening it, but then I decided that I'm gonna do it live on the video, so it's already looks beautiful. It's an amazing gift actually for the holidays as well. So we're gonna talk about this at the end of the video, because I have 6 more tips that I would like to share with you, and then I will tell you how this thing can help you incorporate all the tips that I'm gonna share with you today. Okay, so the first tip was learn how to use calendar. The second tip is to lower the amount of time that you spend in front of your screen. It can be your computer, it can be your cell phone. Every day we spend hours in front of the devices, and our brain gets overloaded. So if you reduce, let's say, your TV time for 15 minutes a day, so if every day you're gonna watch TV 15 minutes less than usual, then at the end of the week you will have almost 2 hours of free time, and you can spend this time on yourself, or, you know, to spend this time with your family. Try to do it. It's a very simple exercise. It's only 15 minutes, but you will see, I guarantee, by the end of the week, you will see the result. And let me know in the comments, write it right now. If you have extra 2 hours per week, what would you do? How can you spend? What would you like to do with this 2 hours of free time every week? Okay, let's move to the step number 3, or tip number 3, how to lower stress in your life. And step number three is to do 15 minutes relaxation. And when I say relaxation, it can be anything. It can be meditation, it can be stretching, it can be yoga, it can be just walking around the neighborhood, it can be drinking a tea in silence. The most important key here is that it is a relaxation time. So if you are drinking coffee and you are watching YouTube video or you are reading a book or you are checking your Facebook, your brain is not relaxing. Your brain is actively thinking, analyzing, and trying to keep track of the information that's coming inside of you, inside of your head. So when you have your 15 minutes of relaxed time, it should be 15 minutes of relaxation. So put your phone aside, don't call your friend, don't watch TV, don't browse the Facebook, just, you know, relax, do nothing. You can walk, you can stretch out, you can meditate, you can drink your tea, you can take a bath, but do not overload your brain when you are doing this relaxation 15 minutes exercise. Let me know in the comments, when was the last time when you spent 15 minutes in your time in silence, doing nothing? For me, it was, that's a really good question. For me, probably it was, last week when I went to Hawaii with my husband. And when I was waiting for him, he was getting ready in the morning. I remember I was just sitting on the couch, looking through the window, enjoying the beautiful nature, beautiful scenery. But before that, I think it was a while. So I think I will add this tip in my calendar so I'm not gonna forget about it. Let's move on. Tip number four. Tip number four is to do a 15 minutes physical activity. So it's can be exercises, it can be running, it can be just walking, it can be hiking, but physically. When we stress, when we have some anxiety in our life, when we have some worries in our life, we tense our body. It happens automatically. We cannot control it. This is how it works in 99%. Not, of course, I cannot say for all people, but this is how it works for majority of us. So we tense our body. So when we do physical exercise, when we move our body, we can release these blocks or this tension from our body. And when we relax our body, we relax our state of mind. We can think better, we can make a bit better choices and a better decision. So you need to do a simple exercise, again, stretching, hiking, bicycling, walking around the neighborhood for 15 minutes. I don't really care what are you gonna do, it's not that important. The main thing is you have to do some physical thing. You can even dance, you can turn on the music and dance at your own home for 15 minutes. The choice is yours. There are lots of opportunities, lots of possibilities of things that you can do. But remember, 15 minutes of physical activity. Step number five is very simple. Be kind to yourself. It means allow yourself not to be perfect. Allow yourself to make mistakes. Allow yourself to have some free time and do nothing. When you create a plan for the week, allow yourself have some empty spots in your calendar so you can, you know, enjoy this time with your family, on your own, or maybe you're gonna have some unexpected things that you have to do and you have this time, so you're not gonna stress out. So if you have a busy week or busy day and some unexpected problem occurs, you have some time in your schedule to work on this problem and you don't have to stress out too much. Be kind to yourself also includes having realistic expectations of yourself. So again, if you have a calendar, you write, 20 things that you have to do on that day, and those 20 things will take lots of time and effort, then by the end of the day, you will be exhausted. And probably you're not gonna complete all 20 things if there are like big things, and you're gonna feel terrible about yourself. You're gonna start criticizing yourself. So be kind to yourself. give yourself a realistic expectations. Tip number 6 is to spend more time with people that make you feel good. And if you having issue with your sister for the last maybe 2-3 months, then probably your sister, even if she is the closest one, even if she's part of your family, maybe she is not the best person for this tip. So maybe your coworker or your neighbor is gonna be a better person specifically for this exercise. So you need to spend more time with people that makes you feel good. People who believe in you, people who give you compliments, or maybe it's just people who don't criticize you or don't ask you multiple questions. Maybe you can join some book club and meet some people to talk about the books. So think about who in your life, and again, maybe it's just, you know, a person in your local supermarket and you would like to go and buy some fruits in your supermarket just to have a small chat with this person when you are there. So think about people who bring some good feelings in your life and try to see or meet or interact with that person at least once a week. Not much, but it will add some joy into your life, and of course it will lower your stress level. Okay, and the last tip number 7 is find activity that excites you. Again, it can be a new book, it can be a new movie, maybe it's gonna be a new restaurant, or maybe it's gonna be an old restaurant down the street. Maybe it's gonna be a new hiking place. You need to bring joy into your life. And at the beginning, it might sound crazy that you can say, oh my God, like I'm so busy at work with my kids, with the projects, like I don't have time for these things. But think about this. If you are living in a constant stress, then your productivity will go down. And if you're gonna bring some joy and some excitement in your life, then your productivity will go up. So you will be able to deal with your things faster in a more effective way. So when you dedicate some time for things that you like, for things that excites you, this way you're helping yourself to complete your to-do list, to complete your schedule, to complete your project in a faster and more productive way. So every time when you invest in yourself, you are making, you know, all other things in your life easier, better, and faster. This will help you to reach your goal faster and in a more effective and productive way. Okay, and now I would like to introduce the sponsor of this video again, because this calendar, this journaling notebook will help you to incorporate all the tips that I mentioned before. Okay, let's do the opening. It came in a beautiful envelope, first of all. And inside, we have a few things. We have members manual. Oh, that's nice. So here they explain to you how you can use the journal, and they show you that you can use the mood tracker, you can use different colors, you can use a habit tracker. So basically it's like you have your personal coach or personal therapist next to you. And if you like journaling, then you're gonna appreciate this one. Or maybe you have somebody in your family or some of your friends who really enjoy journaling, and this is a cool way of doing it. I actually thinking that I will probably give this as a gift for my older stepdaughter. She's 13, and I think she will really, really appreciate it. Wow, look at this. Okay, let's open the journal. Okay, there are place for notes. There are short instructions how you can use this journaling. Okay, there is a full month in front of you. Oh, there is a patience log. That's a really good. And the sleep tracker. See, there is a sleep tracker. Very useful thing, especially if you're struggling at night. Letter of gratitude. So this journal has unlimited opportunities, and it also have a drawing. You know, I really a fan of art therapy, and I believe the drawing really helps us to lower our stress and anxiety. So here you have it, and you have your notes, and then you have expense tracker. So this is kind of like a personal coach, I would say, personal coach that will help you to manage your life and to plan your life better, so you have more time for your friends and family. And let's look quickly on in this one. I love the packaging. The packaging is incredible. I definitely will get one for my stepdaughter. I think she will be amazed by this one. Oh, and this is November. So I received two calendars for October, and October is obviously gone, and there is a November. And I'm still waiting for the December one. And November, let's see. Okay, it also has to-do list. Mm-hmm. Meal plan, mind body health plan, shopping list, specifically useful for December for all the gifts that we have to purchase, right? Again, shopping list, that's good. And there are some inspirational quotes. Wow. Oh, look at this owl. That's amazing. Owl is a symbol of wisdom. In art therapy, each symbol has some meaning, and it's good to know when you are doing some drawing. You can just Google the symbolic meaning of different animals or different elements. And when you're gonna, you know, draw, you can think about the meaning of this symbol, and definitely you will aim your subconscious into that direction. So again, thank you Silk and Sander for sponsoring this video. I definitely recommend to check them out, and you can find the link below the video. Again, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe, because in my channel I share useful tips that will help you to become happier and healthier and more successful in life. See you next time. Bye.